everyone, welcome. It's Heidi back today for another handbag review. It's been a while since I've been on. It's had a lot of things going on, some sickness in my family and things like that. I think everybody's been dealing with that. But anyway, I wanted to go ahead and review some bags that I've received recently. I actually may just try to just do like a little mini marathon here of several bags that I have recently purchased, or it's been within the last couple of months. Anyway, I want to start with this one. This is by Go Forth Goods. This is their sort of newish, I would say, in the last 4 or 5 months or so. They did put out this new size Avery. This one is the small crossbody, and it's in the color saddle. This one actually was not one that had been on my radar or anything like that. I love the medium Avery. I've reviewed that one. That's my favorite size. So I really wasn't too interested in the small, just based upon the fact that I love the medium. So anyway, when this one came up on the buy sell trade on the Go Forth Goods Groupies page, I fell in love because of the hide. I mean, look at it. It's amazing. I love those striations. Those natural lines like that get me every time. Like I just didn't need this bag, but I had to have it. And when I got it, still I even thought, well, maybe I shouldn't have bought that. But once I carried it just one time, I knew that this might even replace the medium Avery for me, just in terms of not necessarily the size, but the style. I really enjoyed carrying it on the crook of the arm like that. And also crossbody. It's very comfortable. I've had the mini size before, and it suited my needs perfectly as far as size. But this one is maybe just a little bit better because it's not so stuffed. Like my things just fit inside the mini, and which is fine. But this one feels a little bit more relaxed because it's not as full. The back side of the hide is very pretty too. It is different from the front. It doesn't have those really beautiful stretch marks, but it is does have a lot of variation in color, very squishy soft. And the more you carry these saddle leather bags, the more squishy and malleable they become. They just become very soft. But not in the sense of like floppy. It does still have some structure. So let me go over some of the specs of this bag, and I will keep this short because I have reviewed Go Forth Goods several times before. This one is full grain leather, of course, and it's 6 ounce American leather. So this is a very substantial thick leather product. Very soft on the interior. And the outside is soft too, but it's not the type of leather that easily scratches, the ones that show scratches really easily. Like this is a bag that you do not have to baby. You can carry this in the rain, snow, it doesn't matter. It's not gonna hurt it. You don't have to pre-treat it. You don't have to worry. It's just a really great all-weather leather. It does come with a lifetime guarantee. So these are handmade in Marietta, Georgia. And it comes with a lifetime guarantee. So if anything was to go wrong, like rivets, you know, I don't know what could happen, fallout, hardware failure, or anything like that, he will replace those things. The handles, I'm not sure what the drop is on this. Let me see, I have my tape measure here. Let's just see. I think it's 5 inches, but I didn't write that down. So let me look. So let's see. From the drop, it is, it's 5 inches. So you have a 5-inch drop. So this is not one that you're gonna wear, you know, as a shoulder bag. It just doesn't fit that way. It doesn't look right. But it's really nice for grab and go, like in the car. These handles come in really handy. If you're just the type of person that wants to wear it just solely crossbody, the handles are still very convenient. This is a 10 ounce leather. And they do have the little logo on the straps, both handles. But really that's the only place that this bag is actually branded, is just on the straps. Does it have a brand inside? No, it doesn't. I didn't think it did. Okay, so this bag is 10 inches in height. So you have 10 inches here, and you have 11 inches in your width, and then a 4-inch depth. And this bag does not have feet. He does offer a brass feet option, so if that's something that you want, you can always add that. You can also customize by adding a front pocket, and you can opt for a hemmed edge. Now this one, I didn't order this one specifically. I bought this from the Buy Sell Trade, so I didn't, you know, have those options, but I like buying from Buy Sell Trade because you know exactly which hide you're getting. And I am kind of picky. I admit I'm kind of picky, but when it comes to this variation and things like this, I love it. That's something that I just prefer. So anyway, this one is the raw edge. I do believe that changes the height, maybe just by like a 1/4 inch, 1/2 inch, something like that. If you opt for it to be sewn down, like there, have a hemmed edge. And you can also customize your strap colors. This one is saddle, which matches the bag, but they do have other options. You could opt for black, natural, which is vegetable tanned undyed leather, or you could get mocha, which is a really nice deep chocolate brown. I'm gonna show you what that looks like really quickly too. And then also I wanted to mention, this bag typically comes with a piece of leather attached to the back that comes over the front that has like a button type closure. It's a very simple, nice closure as well. Again, I didn't choose, but this person who purchased this originally opted for the snap, which I love. I actually was kind of like torn on that too. I didn't know if I would like the snap. I know that I like the button closure, but the snap is great too. I think it's even easier actually. So let me go over the interior really quickly. Let me take my stuff out. Inside, it has two pockets. Two very generous pockets. They are quite low in this bag, and there's a reason. It has to be that way because the way that he has attached the handles, these bottom two rivets are what hold the top of that pocket in place. So the pockets are kind of low in the bag. They kind of almost sweep over the bottom, but that's fine. I really don't fill those anyway. I have a few things in there. I have some cash and gum and a mirror. So it's not like I have to use those pockets a ton, but the interior is amazing. It's so super soft. It's that suede side of the leather. It smells amazing. And you can see how thick that is. Very high quality leather. And I want to compare this to my medium. Oh, and they also come with a really cute little keychain to match your handle color. And then, you know, you have the key keeper there for your keys. But let me compare this to the medium, because I think that's what most people are wondering. Like, how is the small compared to the medium as far as size? Here's my medium. And I love this bag too. So this is just solely a shoulder carry, which is great. I mean, so I have options now. This one will probably be for, you know, quick grocery trips and things like that. But just to put these side by side for you. Do I have these actually side by side? I think I do. So you can just kind of get a quick idea of the size difference. And this one's stuffed with tissue paper, so kind of mimics having things inside. I don't know if I can do this way or not, but let's try. You can kind of see that makes it look a lot bigger, doesn't it? Let me kind of line them up. It is quite a bit bigger actually, though. There we go. So you can just kind of see the differences. And I will try this on for you too, so you can kind of see how it fits on 5'5". I have it on the shortest setting, and then you just have a typical belt-like adjuster here. And I love the shoulder pad. I just love that. I don't think this bag particularly needs it. I don't think it's gonna be like a really extremely heavy dig in your shoulder type of bag, but I love that little extra leather piece. I think it just adds to the uniqueness of it and makes it a little bit more special. But anyway, I have this on the shortest setting and it's still kind of long for me. I thought about, you know, just adding a few more holes because I do have room to where I can, this tail can come all the way down to here without it looking silly, I think. So I may do that, like, and so just so that I have the option of carrying it just on the shoulder without it hanging too low. Crossbody, I think it's fine for 5'5", but it's borderline long. So just thought I would mention that. And then I want to show you what I got my mom for Christmas. I haven't given it to her yet, just because with the whole, you know, COVID thing, we haven't gotten together. We're gonna get together tomorrow, actually. So we wanna make sure everyone's well, you know, and able to see each other without, you know, spreading the stuff any further. But anyway, this is her Christmas gift. This is the Jane. And she is a, through and through, she loves the barrel bag shape. And it's kind of hard to find, actually. There's not a lot of barrel type bags out there. And if you do find one, they're usually like so small that you can't fit anything inside. So this was a really good option for her. It has a really nice, you know, size and things like that. So I think she'll really like it. But this is the saddle leather, and I love the character. Look at the character on this. Isn't that gorgeous? And then her straps, or the ones that come on the Jane standard with the saddle, are mocha. So that's just the standard color for this. And I think it looks really fantastic with this bag. So, and it has the same, you know, setup. You have the extra shoulder pad. And the zipper pull does have a little piece of leather on it to make that a little bit easier. Nice zipper, nice strong zipper. And then it has one pocket on the interior and lots of room. So I'm excited to see her start to carry this one, but I thought I would just share that one. She's gonna wrap that one up here in a little bit. All right, and so now I'll try this bag on for you. Okay, so here's how the bag looks on crossbody. I find it to be very comfortable. Like I said, the only thing that I would change is maybe bringing it up just a little bit higher. It is very comfortable here though. Doesn't feel like it stands out really far from the body. That's one thing I really don't like when wearing crossbody. But I think this would probably be like the max size that I would feel comfortable with crossbody. But it does not feel overly like large for crossbody to me. And it's fairly lightweight, it's not super heavy. But if I switch this to the long shoulder carry like this, I think that's when I'm kind of crossing the line as far as it hanging too low. It feels just a little bit uncomfortable at this length. So I will probably end up either taking this to like a leather shop or something and having them add some extra holes. Or, you know, I might, because the strap is removable, I could always switch it out for a different strap, but I really don't want to do that because I really like this one. I like, you know, I like the matching straps and I really like Go Forth Good straps. I feel like they're very comfortable on the shoulder. So, and these handles, like, these do not get in my way. Like, I thought that might be an issue, but they're not super stiff at all and they're going to soften up over time. So those really don't bother me at all. Okay, so that will do it for today. If you guys have any questions about Go Forth Goods products, any of the products that I've reviewed or showed you, or any specific questions, please feel free to ask. I always enjoy watching your videos of your bag reviews. This is just a fun hobby for me. So leave your comments, questions, anything like that. Ideas for future videos is great too. And as always, I appreciate you watching and I hope you have a great day.